Thank you. So we are a bit late, a bit delayed, but I hope we can make it in time. After all, I prepared the slides for a 5-minute lightning talk, so there should be enough. So Queryograph of AskRart, it's not so much about technical detail, this lightning talk, but rather about user interface, so a query language that you can use for querying graphs. If you have a graph, then it consists out of vertices and edges or nodes and relationships or with properties, but it's really hard to find the patterns for the trees, right, or for the graph, actually. So you look at a pretty force-feed visualization, but it's really hard to discern patterns. That's why we can, for instance, use a query language to finding them. So we have a graph here. Somewhere in there are patterns, but we don't see them, right? So we can, as you can see up there, we can describe patterns by drawing nodes and relationships and saying, okay, that's the pattern I'm looking for. That is what it should look like. And then we can say, okay, these are my starting points in the graph, the green ones. So these are the bound nodes that I want to see these patterns on. And then I can find them on these bound nodes. Please note that it takes into account the direction of these arrows, so the direction of the relationships. So we find some patterns in the graph, actually just 3, and the third node doesn't have any patterns because the relationship directions don't match. So that's a way to find patterns in the graph, but of course you can do it programmatically, but it's a bit tedious and not so easy to do. So what we thought is we create a query language with pattern matching. Of course, there is already a query language of pattern matching for graphs. It's called Sparkle. But outside of academia, most people have quite a lot of problems getting along with Sparkle. So we thought we take some inspiration from other sources, like SQL, like something that I quickly come to. And so we developed Cypher, a query language for Neo4j. As you probably know, Cypher is one of the villains in Matrix. And as Neo4j is very matrix-related, so we chose this name. So of course I can draw patterns on a whiteboard, that's not a problem at all. I do it all the time when I'm discussing stuff or when I'm creative, then I just draw or sketch or doodle patterns. But how would you draw them in a query language? Because it's, you know, it's all text. Of course it's easy to draw patterns, we just use AskRart. You know, when you remember back in the times of mailboxes and online text adventures and so on, there was always AskRart around, so really pretty pictures and stuff like that. So it's not hard to just take letters and arrows and kind of put up your pattern as AskRart. So you can also not just specify multiple patterns, but also the reverse direction of arrows, so you just have to have one expression for describing this pattern above. So the mapping is quite simple. We just map nodes to identifiers, optionally with parentheses, so it looks nicer. And relationship labels or relationships are mapped to arrows. And for instance, you can put labels into square brackets. For another example, our variable length paths in the graph. So you want to see all the people that I'm connected to 3 steps ahead. So my friends of a friends of my friends. And I can just use a star or a star with a max length identifier for that. So also complicated paths can be easily expressed with that. Some more advanced examples. So one is find me the skills of a user. So up there you see the SQL equivalent with all the tables and table rows stacked on top of each other. And on the right side there's a graph representation, where the nodes are the squares and the relationships are the connecting tubes. And down here, there's the Cypher representation of this query, where I just start with a user. A user is connected with a relationship labeled user skill to the skill, and we just return the skill and the user itself. Another example is find me the friends of my friends. So I don't go through this query, but it's just me, my friends, and the friends of the friends, and then I can do filtering and ordering and aggregation and stuff like that as well. The next one is a simple recommendation, collaborative filtering. So stuff that I rated that other people also rated, and what else did they also rate? Because that might be interesting for me, especially if I take into account that my ratings and their ratings are very similar, so very close to each other. So what I liked, they also liked, and so I looked what else they also liked. So can I can buy more stuff because, you know, that's what it's all about. Cypher returns tables, actually, because human brains are kind of predefined to work with lots of data and tables. They only use, so humans just use graphs in creative work. So probably we should do more creative work for doing that. And we can also return graphs, for instance, for visualization or highlights or exports. There's a small console that I wrote some time ago that you can use online to create graphs and query them and visualize them. And it's kind of a mixture of between a repo, a gist, like GitHub gist, and a sandbox, because you can try out all your stuff that you want to try out. So it's online on console, Neo4j.org, and easy to get going. Some stuff around stuff, I don't know. Time left? Okay. So what we got in there, some goals for that was we want to use SQLite patterns, we want to use pattern matching, we want to steal some stuff that we like about SQL. We don't steal everything from SQL because it's not structured query language, or but a graph query language, and it's an external DSL, so it's passed with Scala parser combinators into expression trees and executed on the Neo4j graph database. And if you're interested in how these things all relate together, then you can have a look at the slides and see how each of the clauses of Cypher influences either the graph or the results or the patterns in the graph. That's it. Thanks a lot.